Rwanda drive for holistic development calls for a very, very sound PFM. And therefore, the role of the Auditor General is to be a vanguard of that vision as far as the PFM is concerned. And let us also remember that how do you bring PFM into the whole bigger subject of corporate governance? These days, everything has become corporate. And therefore, the subject of corporate governance really has to be central to the development agenda of the country, Rwanda. And the PFM must be sound, built on very sound, firm principles. And that brings in the professional accountancy organizations, like ICPAR, for example. So the practitioners have to give it some bigger consideration, the bigger picture, than I commonly see 10 years later after the setup of ICPAR. You cannot divorce ICPAR from Minucofin. Minucofin has to understand that it is the supervisory agency of the PFM, which PFM is actually the cornerstone of whatever you call development. When you talk of development, talk of GDP. How do you define, what are the components of GDP? How do you account for them? There is a country somewhere I know, whereby somebody, I think IMF, that 60, it's foreign debt, is 60% of the GDP. But sincerely, has the accounting been done properly? So if not properly, it remains guesswork. Now, I liked this paragraph number 4 of the IFAC letter to me, which features the G20 call to action, focused on public finance management as one of the priority actions in IFAC's recent G20 call to action. If these giants like G20 are recognizing that fact, how about Rwanda? So the PFM has to be enshrined properly and visibly in the vision of Rwanda, and the role of the Auditor General sincerely cannot be overemphasized. That's how I see it. But for me, I always want to focus on accounting, the PFM strategy, accounting. That accounting must be complete. Complete accounting means what? Accounting completely for activities of the nation, transactions of the nation, as they happen, not when you have paid the cash or when you have received the cash. That cash you pay, which at point zero was not properly accounted for, because cash movement in and out is a consequence of what? Of the cause. So if you did not account for the cause at point zero properly, even that cash becomes part of the incompleteness. So if this COVID emergency found you in an incomplete accounting stance environment, I'm telling you, you have chaos. You have seen it in the countries. You have had. So that accounting as an invention, it produces what? Accountability. Please, accountability without proper complete accounting, you are deceiving yourself. Therefore, that accounting I'm talking about produces accountability. And the accountability produces transparency. But we always go sloganeering. We start with transparency. When you ask someone to define transparency, you get almost zero answers. What are the priorities and the challenges? The priorities, as I said, please let us maintain, let us define properly, maintain complete accounting. The challenges are resistance to that completeness of the stakeholders, of the key players. Look at a simple, let me call it simple, an accounting standard, international accounting standard, IS-1. You can call it simple presentation of financial statement, isn't it? For those of you who may be accountants. But that one has to be properly supervised. And let us say the PFM, it must start from the Murenge, going up to district. All sectors of the government, professional development must be continuous. But you can't continue a journey that you don't know, that has not been properly defined. So the key success factor number one is the people and the people and the people and the people. What do I mean? That is a key success factor. Then, indeed, accountability in the country. How are we rated as a country? The corruption, is it corruption tendencies, corruption zero tolerance, etc. I can assure you, if you talk of fighting corruption and you do not have that complete accountability, as I said earlier, you are deceiving yourself because you are not using the scientific tools to fight corruption. Therefore, we have been providing that scientific tool. Anyone who cares to use it, I can assure you, you will do a very good job in the PFM. But this far we have come, a long way, we still have to go, and therefore, we need to do better than we have done. But where we are in Rwanda, we are doing well. In East Africa, we are number one. In Africa, I think we are number four.